Chris Kehler Holistic.
Hey, Chris, what's going on?
I'm doing perfect. How about yourself?
It's doing good. We're doing good here.
Well, glad you are able to spend a little time with us today.
I checked out some of your other your YouTube videos and some of the other interviews and stuff. Sounds like you cover a lot of... Yeah, I'm gonna grill you a little bit on one topic because you have... On one show I was listening to, you hit a certain topic that's a favorite of mine, so we'll get into that
all right.
A little later. But it sounds like you really... have some interesting different healing modalities that you practice. And I would imagine this came about not getting help from the white coats, as one of our hosts calls it, of the mainstream medical community. Do you want to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Basically, I am an energy healer. I work with quantum energy, God energy, whatever you want to call it, the energy of the universe that is available for all of us to use in whatever way we want to use. So if you look at all the different types of healing modalities, all the different ways to do it. All it's doing is taking that energy and you're using it, you're molding it to do what you want it to do in the way that you want it done. So, you know, there's all these different ways of doing it, EFT, quantum touch, Reiki. And the way I do it is specific to the way I understand it and the way that I want it to work for me. Basically, I can take any kind of health problem whatsoever. Doesn't matter what it is. Quite lately, I've been working on a lot of people who are experiencing trauma within the whole universal soldier aspect of things, where your body is off somewhere else fighting a war. So there's a lot of that been happening. I work deep at the soul level. I work deep within all the etheric bodies. I also work on the physical problems. So that's kind of where I differ, is that I do look at the spiritual and I do look at the physical. I'm able to very quickly heal and cure basically any health problems. I got started in this, it's been about 9 years now. My first wife passed away. And when that happened, it enabled me to retire from the printing industry where I was for about 30 years. That was my trade. I loved doing it. It was a craft. And I enjoyed it, working with, you know, multi-million dollar equipment and almost being an artist with a printing press. So once I stopped doing that, the old saying goes, one door closes, another door opens. I met somebody who did this type of work while I wasn't working, and I just really took a very big look at it and said, wow, this is incredible. I need to do this. Something just told me. Spirit said, you know, and at the time I didn't really realize it, but Spirit said, this is you. This is what you got to do. Started taking some courses to learn about the whole thing. Got into radionics. I got into using the metaphysical tools. Started dowsing with a pendulum, and it's just escalated and escalated into itself in the last, say, 6 years to where I have my own practice. I'm in a healthcare center, and I work with people on a daily basis, 9 people a day, 5 days a week, and the schedule is growing and growing and growing. And the most important thing is that people are getting relief from their health problems. People are getting relief from the depression. People are getting relief from anything that's plaguing them. And it's working. Ultimately, we're doing work of the universe. We're doing God's work, work of love and light. And we're getting rid of all of this junk, all of this garbage that humanity has been plagued with for centuries.
Yeah, that's awesome. I saw you have a phrase for light workers you use that I like. You think you call them shiny people.
Shiny, we're shiny people. Yes, we are.
Shiny people.
Our light is a little brighter than most others, especially people who haven't awakened yet. If you're a shiny person, of course, now you're a bigger target. Majority of my clientele are light workers who, on a daily basis, they work on people and they get hit, they get attacked. We do have very big clientele of actual light workers.
Yeah, I was looking here at your website. You also have you do the the blood analysis, the dark field.
Yeah, that's a wonderful way to complement the whole system that I have. If you're in Winnipeg, Canada, where I am, and you come into my office, we can start looking for your health problem with the pendulum. And then if the pendulum says you have parasites in your blood, well, we can take a drop of blood from your finger, put it in the microscope and we can see parasites. So there's good confirmation that we're on the right track, number one. And number two, that, you know, you, the client now feels better knowing that we're going to deal with this problem.
Yeah, because I have a friend in Missouri that works with that. He's part of the NEMNHA, and they do the dark field
microscopy,
yeah. But I thought they did that with me one time. That was really cool to see, you know. And they could tell, you know, in your blood, they could see what was wrong, where you need to improve, and things that you had to work on. Really interesting. So it was cool to see that when I was looking through that. Pretty nice.
Yeah, I like to use it a lot. I bought it as a toy, basically, to take a sample of the blood and then do some energy work. And then a little while later, look at the blood again and see if the blood changed.
Oh, yeah,
and absolutely. Sometimes you can actually have nasty-looking blood on the screen, do some energy work on it, and before your eyes you can see the blood cells start to change on the screen. So it is a really cool tool to educate people, to show them how things work, but ultimately it is a good tool also to find the health problem.
And I think people sometimes need to see things. You know, it's one thing to tell them and explain to them that, oh, you know, do you need to improve on this? But when you're actually looking at your own blood, you're looking at your own cells, your own things inside of you. I mean, it makes a big difference, and especially with someone who knows what they're doing, it even, you can help them get to that place they need to be. Then you can kind of say, hey, this is what we would do. This is what we need to work on. I'm kind of guessing that's probably what you do, maybe, at some level.
It is. Bring people up from a very low state, and you can see it within the blood, if the blood is healthy or not. I did a test with it. I took a sample of my blood, looked at it, and said, well, this ain't the Aldi's-looking blood. I did a juice fast for a week, looked at it again, and the blood cells looked like brand new. They were really healthy, nice and loose. They were full. They were full of nutrients.
Part of, we learned the terrainist type of theories, you know, where we understand that the body, you know, creates, you know, fungi inside of it. The fungi is in there, but it starts to, when the body starts to break down, when you start getting sick, it starts to create these medusels and it starts to attach, and the cells were designed to die at some point and break down, but let's have some quality of life in the process.
I should have mentioned this up front, but if you guys want to check out Chris's website, it's www.chriskehler.net. That's C-H-R-I-S-K-E-H-L-E-R. And you do many different interesting healing modalities. One of them that jumped out at me was the crystalline energy, where you use pyramids.
Yes, that is my mainstay. That is where I shine, let's say. Okay, we're going to use that word shine again. The crystalline tools are all pyramid in nature. There's some rings that I use, and it's all sacred geometry. And what sacred geometry is different shapes, pyramids, circles, squares, rectangles, all this geometry, when it's used in a specific way to create the tool, it does command the energy to do specific things. So the neutralization ring that I have, and we'll do a demonstration on it right away so you can see how it feels. The neutralization ring has spikes in it that face inwards, and you can see it on my website. And this is designed to remove negative energies off of your body. So if you walk by somebody through their field, you might pick up a little bit of negativity off of them. If you're watching the news, you're going to get negativity off of that. So this ring is designed to remove the negativity, and it's great to start a session with because it kind of cleans off the body a little bit. Let me grab that ring. And anybody who's listening right now, you can feel this energy very strong, and it is there. So I'm going to hold it up to the phone. Anybody who wants to stand up. So, guys, stand up, and you're going to get the full benefit of feeling this energy. So ultimately, anybody who's listening, if you're close by, you're going to feel a heaviness within your body. You also might feel very off balance, or you might feel some tingling or heat. So generally, it takes a few seconds. Let me know, guys, when you feel something happening.
Yeah, just stand away from Mark a little bit. There you go. I don't want that kind of feeling.
And if you've got a chat room going, anybody who wants to chime in, give a testimonial that you're feeling something. Anytime I do a radio interview, I use these tools as a demo, and sometimes the responses are quite overwhelming.
We do have people in the chat room, and I just asked them to stand up, and hopefully they can hear. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, ready?
I do feel some...
Okay. There's some movement.
I'm feeling some tingling.
And everybody generally feels a little something different.
I feel it down in my calves a little bit.
I'm feeling it in my mid and in the torso.
Okay.
I got, like, really warm all of a sudden, too.
Nice. So that is yanking off. We'll finish with that. You guys can have a seat and relax. So there's a quick demonstration of what the tools do. This neutralization ring I use, it's a professional model. It's a cost about $360. I do sell smaller versions for $50 on my website. Anybody can buy those and use them on a daily basis and get benefit out of them. The pyramids that I use, we have a new design. We've been using lately the design from the Great Pyramids of Egypt, where the slope is 1.61 degrees. And we recently discovered that slope itself is designed to lock the planet into 3D. So what we did is we changed the slope of our pyramids to 1.72, which is a doorway to 4D and 5D. So it'll open the doors into different dimensions. And what we did is we created a pyramid system within a tool that we call Vesica Pisces. And this tool contains three different types of geometry. It contains the circles, the pyramid, and a rectangle. Mm. When using this tool on people, it conducts a different type of energy, where the neutralization ring will remove negativity. This thing, you can give consciousness to it. You can tell it what to do, and you better be standing out of the way if you don't want to receive it, because it is very, very powerful. It's probably one of the most powerful tools in the universe. Now, you guys want to feel this, don't you?
Yes.
But you're tempting us, aren't you?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm all about the show. Okay. I'm just going to switch over my microphone. So we're going to do something called the sweep. And for this, I want you to stand up again. You don't have to, but to get the ultimate feeling out of it, we're going to get you to stand up.
Let me stand over there.
So I'm going to start sweeping this from the ground up into the sky. And you're going to feel some movement. And what this does by doing this movement is it pulls all the veils, all the negativity, all of the entities out of your field so that your body can respond much better to an energy session. Let me know when you feel that.
I felt like a pulsing, like up my spine.
Good. So now, by doing that, you're now ready for a full energy session.
And that's about it.
Yeah.
There he is. I just felt relaxed.
Felt like a sweep up my spine, then like something like went out my crown chakra.
Yeah, it definitely did a clearing of general entities that might be hanging on, and that's spirits that are just kind of wandering around and they cling on to you because you're shiny. So by getting rid of those guys, then it creates a higher level of healing, a higher possibility of healing, and it happens a lot quicker. Instead of doing 5 or 6 sessions, we can do a healing in 2 or 3 sessions. It does speed up the process, and we're able to be more accurate with the pendulum. Now, ultimately, when you're doing this type of work, you need to identify things. You need to be able to know exactly what it is you're working with. So if it is an entity, you need to know within a certain percentage what type of entity is it. Is it an extraterrestrial? Is it a violent spirit? Is it some type of voodoo spell? You have to identify it. And what the pendulum does with the chart system that I developed is it gets very intricate and precise into exactly what the problem is, where it is, and then what to do to clear it out. The system I developed is not from a course that I bought. This is something I developed on my own when I got started. I took 3 different courses, put them all together, took all the good stuff, and started making my own charts. And over the years, as I've been doing this, been finding new things to work with, new different scenarios. And when you get to that depth, it does constitute a very, very quick healing.
An ascension process that is going on, to use the lucky catchphrase that's going around, kundalini rising or chakra alignment, whatever. I know there's various similar terms going around. I have noticed a lot of, just in myself and people around me, a lot more things trying to attach themselves to us. You kind of mentioned that briefly from, heard you talk about reptilians on one show, and ETs and other things, and you gave a really good description of how the shiny people are kind of attracting these entities now, because everything's kind of, you know, the ascension process moving into the 5D is really picking up now. And, you know, astrologically, we are at the height of that right now, between now and March 20th. And so if you maybe could go in a little bit as to what kind of things are clinging on to people and why they are doing so. You'd given a very good analogy about on one show about, I think it was about smoking, about where if somebody couldn't smoke anymore, they would attach themselves to a 3D entity where they could smoke.
Yeah, there's a lot of, right now with the whole process of vibrating at a higher resonance going into the 5D aspect of things, and we just use the word 5D so we can wrap our heads around exactly what's going on. There are a lot of energies and entities that are being vibrated out of the planet, and as they're leaving, they're grabbing onto us because they don't want to go because they're enjoying it so much here. If there is spirit that was a smoker when they were alive and that they want to enjoy the sensation of smoking, they will inhabit somebody who does smoke and cause that person to smoke more. If they like to drink booze, same thing. The whole aspect of find something that is kind and attached to it and then enjoy what is happening. Now, the whole thing with extraterrestrials, that's a whole different story. These son of a guns, they got to go. They've been here for eons. Working on our DNA, trying to get the codes for ascension, trying to fix their own DNA. And they're also involved with a big thing called the Super Soldier Project, MK Ultra, MI Labs, that whole aspect where they take your holographic body and they put it on the planet Saturn to fight the war. There's a big, huge war going on Saturn, and they're using us to participate in that war. There's been agreements with the governments in order for them to be able to do that, and these things are happening. And I am pulling people's holographic bodies off of Saturn, making a few adjustments. All of a sudden, their health problem goes away. Because ultimately, through quantum entanglement, if your energy isn't on another planet and you are here on Earth, whatever happens to that energy on the other planet or wherever it is, you will feel an effect on Earth because it's the same energy. To deal with a health problem, you need to go into these depths to find all of this type of stuff. So everything is vibrating out. The big thing is the god realm, the demigods, all of the Greek gods, Egyptian gods, Aztecs, Mayans. They live in this realm where they're sitting around playing cards, smoking cigars, and then they put the cards down and say, let's play with the humans for a little while. And then they'll cause all these wars. They will cause the famines. It will cause the weather disturbances to see how we react, what we do. It's just like us taking a bunch of mice, putting us in a maze, and then putting up little barriers to see what they'll do. Exact same thing. As above, so below. So all of this stuff is vibrating out, and it is getting to a level where it can't exist anymore. Now, the fellow who makes my tools, his name is Wayne Gatos. He's in Alberta, Canada. And what his job is to clear out the Earth grid of all of these dimensions, all these lower dimensions. On the weekend, if anybody felt any kind of energy shifting, if you felt very tired all of a sudden, the dimension of hell was cleared out. So hell does not exist anymore. That has been done. The first and second dimensions are cleared out so that these entities, all these dark things, lower vibrational entities, don't have anything to attach to. They're just kind of floating around in the wind. Now they're a lot easier to get rid of when you do an energy clearing. It's just like instead of trying to kill a wasp or a mosquito and you're having trouble hitting it, now you just kind of wish it away and it is gone. So that the whole vibrational rate of the planet, the Schumann resonance, is rising. Things are vibrating out and some people are getting smacked on the back of the head as they vibrate out, if you will.
So I'm curious about this. You know, you're talking about there's this war on Saturn. I'm really curious about that. I mean, how did that come about? How did you discover that? I mean, are we missing the message here someplace? I mean,
every time I use my pendulum, the consciousness that I am working with is a high-level consciousness. You can call it love and light. You can call it son of love and light. You can call it whatever you want. It is a very high-level consciousness. And I have a letter chart, and it spells things out where some people get telepathy messages or words or thoughts that come into their head. My modality is the pendulum. It'll spell things out. And if I'm working on somebody, and I'll say, what do I need to do in order to help this person heal? And it'll spell out, remove them from Saturn. And I was like, what? What do you mean by that? And mm-hmm. it'll say they are fighting a war on Saturn. And it's like, okay, let's go with it. Because ultimately, sure. you got to do what it says. Otherwise, mm-hmm. you're doubting it. You must just put it down and go get a real job. So I keep on working with this, and it keeps on coming up. And then you learn more about it as you work with it. For me, the proof is always in the pudding. If you sure. do A, B, and C, and element OP goes away out of a person, then you know there's got to be some validity to it. The concept that I work on, and this is just my concept, is that there is a war being fought on Saturn energetically. There's not people in 3D form running around in spacesuits waving wooden swords around.
Right.
This is all an energy etheric type of war. And the knowledge that I have is that the rings of Saturn are at play here. So the rings of Saturn are actually souls. That's where souls are kept. And there's a battle over the souls, because ultimately souls are like currency within the universe. So if a dark force can get your soul, if they can cause you to commit suicide, they now have your soul. They can now trade it on the black market in the universe for whatever they want.
Oh, okay, I see. Because it's funny, because I think I was talking to you, Mark, that, you know, about my dad. He worked for the government, and he mentioned to me that we're down in these old ancient places like Iraq, Iran. We want to get into Iran so bad, but there's so much alien technology there that we're actually fighting these aliens, but we kind of making it look like it's not aliens, you know?
Mm-hmm.
My dad kind of mentioned that to me because he worked for the CIA, and I was whatever, you know?
Yeah, right.
But, you know, now he's telling me this about, you know, the soul energetically, and that there's the dimensional ports that we're actually, they can travel through these dimensions. There is some, like, old stuff that, you know, that people call New Age that, you know, was able... You know, shamans used to be able to go up trees and end up on the other side of the world. You know, the technology is there. We just don't know how to use it, or we've forgotten.
Right, right. Because, I do astrology for a living. That's my main gig.
Mm-hmm.
And so this kind of, you know, what he's saying, too, kind of flows very good with what I've been, you know, telling people for a long time. It's like, you know, my poor analogy that I use... is that, you know, there's 360 degrees of the zodiac. These are all different frequencies vibrating at slightly different levels, just mm-hmm. like you have a radio with 360 different radio stations. And, you know, time is not linear. Time, you know,
right,
we exist on many levels and many places at the same time. So I could see where our holograms being used in other places. And would you say that... on the same level that there are holograms from other places being used here, perhaps, as well?
You know what? You really have to look at things in a broad aspect outside the box. Of course there can be. Now, one concept that I do work a lot with is when these beings come into our planet, they have to come in through our chakra systems. They need an energy port in order to get here. They just can't hitch a ride on a spaceship and land. So that's not done. In order for them to come into this planet, they come through our chakra systems. Now, if you're a person who has a perfectly healthy heart, your diet is perfect, you exercise all the time, but you all of a sudden you get little heart attacks, you get palpitations, that is that heart chakra being used as a portal, and beings are coming in through it.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, that... Let's take a...
That all kind of, that flows pretty good with me, actually.
Now, if you look at the sun, take a look at the sun. If you look at the NASA telescopes, the SOHO A and B, you'll see once in a while there's coronal holes. There's a hole in the sun. That the sun is a huge chakra for large spaceships. Whenever there's a big coronal hole, there is a spaceship coming through.
Okay, so we just had a massive solar flare, like a gigantic one, 2 days ago, I believe.
Yeah, that was a kill shot. It almost hit us.
Yeah.
Yeah, there was a lot of... That makes sense. That makes sense why everything was so weird.
Yeah. Because actually, my talk at Gift of Light Expo is going to be astrology, ascension, and solar flares. So I'm going to tie some of that together for...
We couldn't get on the air last week, remember?
Oh, that's right. That's right. We had all kinds of weird...
There was weird stuff going on. So hold on, boys. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back, okay?
You are listening to WithInsightsRadio.com on the Blog Talk Radio Network, your free online holistic publication resource radio for trusting your intuition, achieving self-discovery, and following your soul self.
You are listening to WithInsightsRadio.com, your free online resource for achieving self-discovery and inspiration,
With Insights Radio is a listener-supported radio station, and your donations are greatly appreciated. We cover a variety of topics, interviews surrounding the metaphysical and holistic and natural medicine alternative healing modalities, and much more. Thank you for tuning in to withinsightsradio.com.
At Chris Kehler Holistic, we demonstrate real healing and real caring to your health issues and needs. Our solution for you is an alternative to the alternative. Our out-of-the-box treatment methods are aimed to your specific well-being and are quite different than most. Venturing down the realm of quantum energy healing, Chris uses unique modalities of healing, such as spiritual intervention with pendulum dowsing, sacred geometry tools such as the neutralization, divinity, and sun ring. Another tool Chris uses is a 5-tiered pyramid affectionately known as the Silver Light Pyramid to activate quantum activity within the body. Also, Chris Kehler Holistic uses radionic technologies in various platforms with specific liquid mineral ionics to balance out excesses and deficiencies within the body. At Chris Kehler Holistic, our goal is to get tangible and measurable results in the least amount of time possible so you can carry on with what's important in your life. Another advantage to this unique energy healing is that it can be done at a distance healing session. So location is not a barrier and can be done conveniently at your home, office, just about anywhere through Skype or telephone conferencing. Eliminate costly protocols, expensive monthly supplements, high-priced allopathic operations, invasive surgeries, and dubious medication applications that keep you trapped in a financial and health rat race. Get a specific, customized, out-of-the-box solution tailored for your health recovery. At Chris Kehler Holistic, we are warm welcoming and want to put you at ease with your visit to us. Please visit www.chriskehler.net for further information as we welcome your questions and inquiries to starting this unique journey. At Chris Kehler Holistic, we want to show you that we are the alternative to the alternative and the out-of-the-box solution to customize an answer for you to spend less and gain more in your high-vibrancy journey. Visit www.chriskehler.net. Real healing and real caring to your health needs.
And we are back, Lunchtime Wisdom Cafe. Today our guest is Chris Kehler, talking about quantum healing and many other interesting energetic tie-ins to that. So before we got too far away from it, Chris, I wanted to ask you, the pyramid you were talking about with the 1.72 incline there, are those available for sale on your website, or...
They certainly are. There is what's called it's a triple pyramid that we've developed, and of course, why three pyramids? And they're all stacked at 90-degree angles on top of each other. When you look at the base, it creates another form of sacred geometry. It looks like the Merkaba. So the geometry is the key as to why we do a triple. Now, another tool that I have on there is called the Sun Ring, which has a lot of other benefits to it. It's a broadcaster of energy. So we put a sun ring within the pyramid. It just ramps it up to another level of healing potential. And these things sell like hotcakes off my website. The little rings are very popular. The pyramids are very popular. The Vesica Pisces is not a shelf item yet. We cannot carry it and sell it until the universe says it's time. It's a very powerful tool, and we can't let it get into the wrong hands yet.
Awesome. Cool. Awesome. So, yes, go to Chris's website, www.chriskehler.net, and check out the items he has on there. And I think there's also some links to some videos and things like that on there as well. Lots of interesting stuff that I ran across. So, too, I want to ask you about that. For a minute there, we talked about the Schumann resonance frequency. Could you expand on that point a little bit more? But I think you're saying frequency was rising?
Yeah, it's very simple. The vibrational rate allows everything vibrates. You've got an iPhone sitting in front of you. So now that the OtterBox case around it, the rubber vibrates at a certain frequency. The glass vibrates at its own frequency. So the Earth itself has its own vibrational rate. And for the longest time, I forget exactly what the rate was. It escapes me right now. But it was always at a certain vibrational rate. But now, because this ascension process, the Earth is vibrating at a higher rate. So the Schumann resonance, and it was discovered by some guy named Schumann. I'm really smart today, aren't I? Okay. they found this vibrational rate within the planet. And that vibrational rate, the Schumann resonance, we call it, is getting higher. So now what I do find with some people is that their bodies or certain areas are not harmonized with the new rates, and it causes a cancellation of some vibrational rates within your body. So once we harmonize you with the resonance, then things tend to straighten out, let's say, within your body. Now, this is part and parcel with grounding. So if you're walking barefoot on the earth and you're absorbing this vibrational rate, that's why people feel better. That's why it helps with illnesses when you're grounding properly, because you are pulling in this vibrational rate. You're pulling in the negative ions that are all a contributor to the whole process. So that's why it is important to go hug a tree once in a while or walk barefoot. Mm.
I know guys that do that.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I have people tell me frequently, a couple close people, that I need to constantly ground myself. I have problems staying within the correct frequency range because I really easily get into my head and spirit body and out of my 3D body, and it gets a little difficult to get myself grounded sometimes, we'll say.
What you need to do there, there's something called the Vivaxis connection. This is discovered by Dr. Judy Jacka. And she wrote a big book on it. It's a very interesting book. I don't read books because I don't like to be influenced, but this is one book I paid attention to. The Vivaxis is a connection from your root chakra into the core of the earth, and that is a ground that is created 6 weeks before you're born. So wherever your mother is standing at the time, kaboom, there goes your Vivaxis. You're now connected to the earth. And for some people, that connection could get broken or compromised one way, shape, or form, and that's when you can drift off. When you're astral traveling, sometimes it's a little tough to get back, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So this Vivaxis keeps you grounded into the earth. There's also a Vivaxis that goes from your crown chakra into the sun, so that is also an important one.
So how, just, I want to play with this for a minute. So how would one fix this connection or get it? Because I know some other people, too, that are having, like, grounding issues, I guess we'll call them.
Yeah. Now, also, when the Vivaxis is not working properly, that's when people have problems with EMF and ELF frequency. So if a static electricity, the static charge of EMFs and ELFs get built up in your body, and then it creates an issue. So if you're grounded properly, these things can leave your body. Ultimately, the work that I do, I can check your Vivaxis to see, is it connected? There could be some kind of entity within it. There could be a negative energy within it. And just by clearing it out, all of a sudden things feel a whole lot better.
Okay, this is crazy. I just want to point out that neither one of us has talked to Chris beforehand.
Right.
We didn't go over any kind of outline or anything. I had a problem. I had a problem for like 2 days. It was like last Thursday and Friday, or Friday and Saturday, where I could not touch anything. I could not get the static electricity out of my body. I was consistent. I was like, everything I would touch, I was shocking. And I tried, you know, I put the shoes on with the rubber soles. I did all kinds of stuff, and I could not like touch anything or anyone, hardly.
Let's reconnect your Vivaxis right now. I'll get you to stand up, okay? We're going to reconnect your Vivaxis.
Okay.
Hey, reconnect the Vivaxis from the root chakra through the zero chakra into the core of the earth, please. You're definitely disconnected. Okay, your Vivaxis is now connected. How does that feel?
I actually felt something going up my spine again, up to the crown chakra.
You're now connected to the earth.
Oh, welcome back.
Wow. Thank you. That feels much more grounded than I was earlier. I wasn't here earlier. I was really...
Yeah, there's two different types of grounding. There's the feet on the earth grounding. A lot of people get benefit by putting their hands on the earth, on the sand or grass or anything that is organic. Now, a lot of people get a lot of benefit out of that. And then there's this Vivaxis connection. Find her book on Amazon, Judy Jacka, The Vivaxis Connection. It is a lot of information that I did find beneficial. And again, I don't read anybody. I don't want to be influenced by somebody else's opinions or thoughts. All of my knowledge comes directly from source through my pendulum, and that's what I work with. But this one book did make a huge difference in the work that I'm doing.
Amazing.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people are like that. I know.
Sorry.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
I hate to keep jumping backwards on you, but you
leave a
couple topics that I had that have just been
a whole
really
here. Look at you.
That have been really pertinent to me lately. So when I stumbled across this, looking at some of your other interviews and videos, it definitely caught my eye. So, so the different healing modalities you do, I see, have helped with shingles and heart disease, high blood pressure, and things like that, and fertility issues, cancer, diabetes. But what I was more interested in, pertinent to my reality, can help clear demons, curses, spells. And you, at one point, had met, I saw in one interview you mentioned, because I get into a lot of this stuff on my show, on the rabbit hole. I call it dispelling, where you call stuff out. You have to call it out. If you can call it out by name and identify it, then it has to leave if it has attached itself to you. Can you explain that a little better than
correct.
I fumbled through?
Yeah. No problem. Now, 9 times out of 10, when I work on somebody for the first or second time with a health problem, and this is generally a health problem that nobody can seem to help with. Other healers or the medical community, nobody can seem to find what is going on here. There's always going to be a spell or a curse of some kind, whether it's shamanic, witchcraft, black magic, voodoo, jinn voodoo, whatever you call it within whatever you do, there is the intent. Now let's look at a curse or a spell at its very minimal, which is somebody thinking negatively about somebody else and talking behind their back. When you're doing that on an ongoing basis, you're creating a spell within them. You're creating a curse on them. When you flip somebody the bird, you show your middle finger to somebody, you are cursing them. You are basically taking a red felt marker, putting an X on their back for the dark forces to now come in because you have put a curse on them. That is the simplest curse, and I've witnessed that on myself a few times and cleared it out, and all of a sudden things get better. Now you get into the very dark of curses. If you look at the Illuminati, you look at all these different demonic cults and different types of, let's call them churches, that practice this type of thing, that you can take somebody's picture, burn black candles around it, say a few incantations out of a dark book and stab the picture with a knife. Now you've marked this person at a very deep, dark level, that all of a sudden their health gets really, really bad. They have these crazy health problems that are just so obscure that nobody can figure it out. This is all to do with curses and spells. And that is something I work on and lift out of people every day. You name it, doesn't matter the disease or illness, there is a curse or a spell behind it. Now, any kind of curse or spell is all connected to the demigod realm. Greek gods, Egyptian gods, they're the ones who are fulfilling the intent or the prophecy of the curse. They're basically all part and parcel with Lucifer and E.T., and they're all making this happen at a very deep level. By lifting the curse, all of a sudden now you can find the health problem, get rid of it energetically, and the person feels a heck of a lot better.
Awesome. This goes very well in tune with the stuff I talk about a lot from the astrological planetary level, where you know everything is actually some of the old cheesy wizard and sorcerer movies I think are actually pretty on target for like how things really work. You don't have to go stab someone or physically harm them to harm them. Everything, all physics, mainstream boring physics, says that all matter in the universe is just energy condensed to a slow vibration. Mm-hmm. And the thickness or solidness of any object, I'm the same matter as this desk here in front of me. It's just I'm beating at a slightly less dense frequency. I'm not as solid as this desk. So when you can tap into these different, when you can find the frequency level or radio station that something is vibrating or broadcasting on, and you can tap into, disrupt that frequency signal, then you can create havoc with it. And that's what you even see now. At, we're going to jump on a conspiracy vein here for a minute. Not that I ever get off that. But but even you see now, to disrupt rioters and stuff, police and military are using like EMF and EFT stuff to, instead of shooting people or throwing tear gas at them, they can just put out a frequency that makes people feel ill.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why a lot of the, like at the protest sites and stuff now, you'll see the black police van with the little, what looks like the radar antenna thing on top. And it's, they can use those to just put out dissettling or disturbing frequencies that can actually make people ill. And this is all, I mean, Tesla had this stuff figured out a long time ago, and just but as far as it too, about as far as calling stuff out and cursing and stuff, you know, there's a lot of the old the vampire myth, jumping onto the New World Order Illuminati thing here. That's how they use a lot of the programming and tell lie vision programming, as they put you know, it's neuro-linguistic programming, and they put things to create things, they create events, they put things out at a certain frequency, and then we, when we do not dispel or call this stuff out when we see it, or call out the name of the entity or whatnot, we are silently giving our permission to allow these things to happen.
That's exactly it. Now, I do work with radionics, which is the use of frequencies within this device. If I take somebody's frequency, it could be from a hair sample, saliva sample, or a picture, or a voice sample. I capture it in a tiny bottle of water. Now, that water is vibrating at their frequency. So let's say they have the frequency of cancer. So I've got the frequencies, all these different frequencies of cancers, and I put that frequency in the machine next to the person's frequency. Those vibrations cancel each other out so that cancer no longer exists on certain levels. It is a process. It does take a bit of time, and I've kind of gotten away from that, but it does work within the frequency realm of things. And the same thing when you're using the energy tools, you're creating intent. You're saying the words to neutralize and eliminate cancer from this person. The vibration, the frequency of cancer no longer exists, and it just evaporates at an etheric level.
Awesome. Yeah, and you know, to just, I'm really good at coming up with really bad lame analogies for things, or metaphors. But yeah, you know, just to kind of show on a simple level to how this works, it's like if you have your remote control and you're trying to change the channel through your cable box using your remote, mm-hmm. if you have a book or something, you know, if you have stuff stacked on your coffee table, you know, sometimes the remote doesn't seem to work because it's not, you're blocking the connection between your remote and the little red eye on the cable box there. Mm-hmm. You're disrupting that frequency field.
Blocking it. The block. So you have all these products on here, and they're all for sale. You make these, correct? That's what you said. I think you said that, or someone makes them
for
you?
Yeah. Majority of products I make, the tools are made in Alberta, Canada, mm-hmm. by this gentleman I talked about earlier, and mm-hmm. I'm a distributor for him. I use the tools and I sell them because they work so well. We want humanity to be able to experience these, use these, and to be able to
Absolutely.
Benefit from them. With my radionic device, I create wristbands. We've all seen the balance bands that you can buy out there, and they contain negative ions that help balance and strengthen that. So, and I use them as the medium to place a frequency within it. The hologram on that wristband will hold the frequency. So I can put any kind of frequency I want into this wristband. So two that are very successful that work incredibly well are ones for sleep. So if you have trouble sleeping at night, you have anxiety, it's hard to shut your brain off, you wear this wristband and you sleep like a baby. They work very well. Another mm-hmm. one I have is for women. It's to balance hormones. All women know you hit that time of the month where your monthly comes along and the hormones start to go up and down and you get irritable. There's different things going on within your body. And you wear this wristband and things are like a cakewalk, so they do work very well. My wife loves it, and so do I.
Mm-hmm.
So these are things that do work very well. I'm able to put any frequency at all into a wristband, but I only sell things that work well for everybody, okay? I'm not one of these mm-hmm. people who wants to take your money for every little thing that I can think of. It's not about money. It's about helping humanity. There's also a monatomic Ormus gold water that I create that works very well with radionic frequencies, and there's a spray I have. It's like a spray smudge. So if you feel there's an entity around or a negative energy, you just spray this water where the energy is, and it will dispel it very quickly. So, yeah, there's some really neat products. I do carry some shungite, which is very popular for healing, and shungite is great for absorbing EMFs and ELFs. But then again, if your Vivaxis is connected, you don't need it. I do carry some really unique products that people are looking for. So very unique things that are out there. Now, my new website is coming out very soon. I'm going to be launching a brand new website, and there's going to be some new products to watch for. I'm actually going to be offering a course on how to do the work that I'm doing. So I'm going to take all my knowledge, all my education that I've been giving, and I'm going to share it with humanity. And the intent of this is to create a healer within the family, or a healer or a group of healers within the community, so that we can all help each other in little areas throughout the planet.
That's a great vision, actually. That's beautiful. Appreciate
right.
that.
Right. That's.
I guess that's your closing thought, huh? that was beautiful. That was good.
Yeah, I've got. It's funny you mentioned the black shungite there. Yeah, I actually have. I have quite a bit of that, and I've. For people listening out there, I got a bunch of the little black shungite pyramids, and I put them around my electronics. Like, I have them on either side of my laptop and stuff at home to try and curtail that energy.
Now, very important with shungite. Lots of people know about it, and they've been buying it. Shungite will fill up with energy, and you have to clear it out. And the best way to do this, some people will take their crystals and put them in sea salt or in the moonlight overnight. The neutralization rings that I have are perfect for clearing out shungite. So if you have a pendant, you put that pendant in the neutralization ring overnight, and every morning you have a fresh pendant. Same thing with the water crystal. They will absorb certain energies over time. You put the container over the neutralization ring, it'll completely clear out all the energies. Those rings work fantastic, and that's the ring that I used when I did the demonstration early in the show. So that will clear out the shungite, it'll clear out all of your crystals, anything whatsoever you can think of, it'll pull the negative energy out of it.
We do have a question in the chat room, real quick, if you have a sec to answer.
Sure.
They're asking, is his experience that all alien connection to our body, mind, and spirit is negative?
There are good ET out there. Sumerians, Lemurians are all here to help us. It's the gray aliens. Now, there are some gray aliens that are good, just like there's some good humans, there's some bad humans. There is good gray aliens, there's good reptilians. Generally, you know, I remove anything that's negative. So I'm not going to find anything positive, because that's not what we're looking for. But yes, there is good consciousness out there that is here to assist us in the whole process, because ultimately, think about it. We get all these different attacks, all these different things are happening to us. We have no defense mechanism whatsoever against it. General people, people who aren't awakened, people who are awakened, we still don't know everything that's going on there. So there are different types of entities, different ETs that are here to help. And I work directly with Sumerians. That consciousness is in my office all the time. There are good ones, there are bad ones, but yes, indeed, don't worry about it. There's good ones here to help us.
Awesome stuff. Awesome stuff.
If you want to book an appointment, go onto my website. There is a little red button that says book an appointment. Press that button. You can see my schedule, and you can book your own appointment. My fees are $60 per appointment, and we do about 50 minutes worth of work, and we do a lot of clearing. Feel free. Look at my website. If you go on my website, you can also press the YouTube button, and you can see all my little YouTube videos. There's also all my radio interviews have been on there, probably a good 100 of them. I've also got my own radio show on the Pyramid One Network, and that is coming up tomorrow at 5 p.m. Central Time on the Pyramid One Network. So feel free. Have a look at my website. You have a question, email me. I will answer it for you. I'm here for humanity. I'm not here to take your money. I do have a family to support, but I'm ultimately here to help you with any kind of questions or health problems that you're experiencing.
Awesome.
Awesome. Great. Fascinating info. Thank you very much for coming on, Chris.
Yeah, thank you
great
very
stuff.
Much.
You're so welcome. It's been a pleasure.
You take care of yourself, and I'd like to have you on again in the future here, maybe on my show on Fridays, and go down the rabbit hole a little further with the reptilian stuff.
May the love and light be with you.
All right.
Okay, take care,
peace,
my friend.
Brother. Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
That was good.
Yeah, that was good info.
With peace and love, we are going to sign out from here.
All righty.
All right, guys.
Have Ciao.
A great rest of the week.
We'll be right back.